Hey guys, welcome to the channel again. From time to time, our grapple loader might break and we need to recover our installation. And this is what we are going to look at today. Let's get going. So we are now on the GNOME desktop, and what I'm going to do next is to intentionally destroy the grub directory so that we cannot boot anymore into the system. So let's do this by pulling up a terminal, and let me go here full screen and increase the font size, and I'll switch to the root user by typing in su and a dash and my root password. And now I want to go to the boot directory, so I'll type in cd/boot and type ls. And you see we have a grub directory in there, and that's the one I want to destroy. So I'll type in rm-rf for recursive and force, and then grub, and hit enter. Now if I type in ls, our grub directory is gone. So we can exit the root user here by typing exit and close the terminal, and we reboot our machine. And of course, because we deleted grub, we are not going to be able to boot into the machine, but we'll repair it in a second. So as you can see here, grub is now gone. So what we can do is now to turn off the machine basically here. Well, in my case, it's a virtual machine, so I'll have to exit the screen here and force it off, but it simulates a PC anyway. And I have to attach here to my CD the Arch ISO, which is right here. And click Apply, make sure that the boot options are enabled, which is fine. And I can boot up my machine again. And this time we'll boot up in the ISO installer. There you go. So I'll hit Enter here. It's going to take a moment here to go to the login prompt. And there you go. So let me clean up the terminal and type in lsblk. So we have VDA2 here. This is our root directory where our install is. And VDA1 is our EFI directory where grub should be installed. So we need to mount these partitions first. So we'll type in /dev/VDA2. This is under the /mount directory. Remember, this is our installation directory, and hit enter. And we will mount VDA1 into our boot directory. So we'll type in /dev/VDA1/mount/boot. And hit enter. Now we can enter the installation and leave the installer. So we'll type in arch-root/mnt and hit enter. And I'll clean up the terminal. And we can reinstall grub now by typing in grub-install. So --target equal x86_64-EFI. Then we define our EFI directory. So --EFI-directory equal boot. And then the bootloader ID, so --bootloader-id equal grub, and hit enter. There you go, installation finished. Now we need to generate the configuration file, so we'll type in grub-mkconfig-o, and then /boot/grub/grub.cfg. So basically we are telling the system to output, this is the -o option, the configuration into the grub.cfg file, which is under the grub directory, under the boot directory, and hit enter. And now we can exit the installation and return to the installer. So we'll type in exit here and hit enter. And now we can reboot our machine. And if everything went well, we will be greeted by the grub bootloader again. And there you go. Grub is up and running again. So we just hit the installation here. Enter my password, and we are back on the desktop.
So guys, this is how you can recover your installation by reinstalling grub from the Arch ISO. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please hit the like button below and subs to the channel if you haven't already. Subs really helps us out, guys. And if you have any question about the video, please let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.